кофту.
NASA photographer Carla Chofi there in the background, part of the advanced crews that get sent out to the landing site along with all of the critical personnel such as the flight surgeons and the extraction crew.
Okay, he got caught there. Okay, give me a hand, careful. All right, let's lift him up. Take this off a little bit. How are his legs? Is everything fine? Don't be in a rush. Free his legs. Okay.
Ноги освобождай. Пошевели ногами.
Move your legs a little bit. Free your legs, and it will get you out.
Потянули чуть-чуть.
Okay, pull.
Я сам.
Pull a little bit. Let me pull. Okay, did you get caught? Careful.
Хорошо. Я возьму тебя.
Okay, I'll hold you up. Hold on.
Team now pulling out our second crew member.
A little bit more. Okay, lift him up by his hands. Hold his hand. Hold his arm. Okay. Right leg. Slowly. Okay, pull him. Okay. Okay, turn him over. There we go.
Second crew member out of the Soyuz craft, NASA astronaut Tom Marshburn. Still remaining on board, Canadian astronaut Chris Hadfield.
I stay with this.
The astronauts will be carried over to these seats where they can relax for a moment as they're all extracted before eventually being moved over to the medical tent erected about 100 meters away from the landing zone. Once inside that medical tent, the crew will get their initial medical exam. I can see some of the another Russian Mi-8 helicopter just now touching down. So far, 2/3 of our landing crew extracted from the Soyuz TMA-07M space vehicle, all following a nominal touchdown in Kazakhstan. That time again coming at 9:31 p.m. Central Time. Roman Romanenko there, the Russian cosmonaut and Soyuz commander for the vehicle's descent. Meanwhile, the recovery crew preparing the hatchway to extract the third and final crew member, Canadian Space Agency astronaut Chris Hadfield.
Unintelligible. Okay, we can see him.
As you can see, fairly cramped quarters inside of these Soyuz vehicles, and the crew in those Sokol launch and entry suits not able to quite move around as freely as would be nice. So these recovery forces are responsible for getting them out safely.
Okay, I'm getting out. There's no place for the two of us. Okay, pull from the other side. And I could see that it was in a different format. Unintelligible.
Here you can see NASA astronaut Tom Marshburn. He's speaking with Deputy ISS Program Manager Kirk Shireman, who's down on the ground as one of the NASA support personnel for this landing. Also there with Marshburn, Eric Bowe, the Deputy Chief of the Astronaut Office.
Feels good down here, beautiful day.
Yeah, you guys look good. Seats all out work.
Right, so they're going to talk about the fuel situation now.
Like I said, we were kept triple checking. I
sent one to Jessica's guy. He should have been in the wall.
Just a second.
Fall down between the seat and the wall.
But that spacecraft, man, it was perfect.
Yeah. Man, we should have stopped.
It's our senior gear.
They could have come back. They could have landed.
I think it's time to.
What's your name? Ella. Here is some water for you. And there will be some tea in the tent, and the weather is great.
Server will be with Rafi as well.
Okay, and we'll take care of you.
So no fire or anything?
Yeah, I was surprised. Or you can see the soft fire.
Last time, there was almost nobody, and the land was covered in ice. Sat very nicely in our descent vehicle.
And for more Russian Mi-8 helicopters continuing to touch down. Right now, two-thirds of our descent crew already extracted from the Soyuz module.
Okay.
I'm just waiting for Canadian Chris Hadfield.
So one of our